श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। In composition, usage and possession, the human beings, we used to have lot of multiple varieties and grades of ingredients with us. They are composed of different type of ingredients, you know, they are the biological particles. And in usage, we are using various entities. You can just enumerate them in thousands and hundreds. And all of those things are of multiple level of usage and they are composed of different things. And the third thing is whatever we possess, we don't use but possess, holding things, they are also having their own compositions. So first is biological composition. We are made up of different things. We are possessing or we are being circumstantialized by things of different configurative order. We are having the usage by the blessings of the era of expanding and extending civilization. We are using, we are trying to use, and we are trying to filter, we are trying to upload and upgrade the usage of varieties of things with different configurations. On the basis of this thing, there is a common principle or instinct which has made us to have the composition, hold the composition and live in a composition of variable ingredients. And it was just initiated, conceptualized by a process known as creation. The existing things in multitude, in magnitude, in solitude, in polytude, in unitude and omnitude, those things were by the connective emulsion of a hyper spiritual innate and inexhaustible power spirit. All of these variable entities, they came into existence, and we are trying to do lot of things, observing things, knowing things, analyzing things, comparing things, distinguishing things, liking and disliking things, developing things, suppressing things, oppressing things, compressing things, everything we used to as per the expansion or necessity or emergency of the ground. So the first initial base for the existence of all beings is known as creation, and that is a God-given or God-made. The second phase of existence of the world or second phase of knowledge transition is creativity. First thing is creation. So God has given everything to being, or the cosmic spirit that has causated the existence, the composite existence of varieties of things, which they reveal themselves on various grounds. They are different, they are identical, they are proximate, they are distant, they are resemblant, they are distinct. Innumerable variations are there in ingrediential mathematics of the whole cosmos. So the first phase of transition is God created everything and he has given crude substance to us, within which we transform the crude substance into different developmental processes, and that is known as creativity. So creation is the infinite power, primordial power vested in God, and creativity is the second stage of power that is vested in advanced godly intelligence or super intelligence, not superficial intelligence. The second level of phase of transition is creativity, which is there as a symptom and signal of processing of the divine instincts. If a person has creativity, no doubt that is divine in nature. And the divinity will be assured when the creativity results in productivity and utility of mass without any disturbances and aberrations. So first is creation and it's a God work. Second is creativity, that is a godly immanent work that is happening on human intelligence. So we develop each and every particle of God's creation so as to realize the wonders, so as to keep away from the blunders, and also to deal with the maximum utility services for the all-round upliftment of ourselves and our fellow inhabitants of the world. That is known as creativity. That is a godly instinct, and the first thing is a God's prowess. So we should start with creativity, and creativity is the mother of all inventions, and necessity is the father, and danger is the daughter of all inventions. So the first thing is creativity. There are three types of knowledges. One is analytical knowledge, second is creative knowledge. So this style of lecture, that is known as Vedic way of lecture. What is the fundamental of your art? How it has developed and where we are you now? Where you are going to reach? So where you have come from and where you are going to reach, that destination physics as well as the origination science, that is there only in Shastras. And the sandwiched, interim, unpredictable, capricious moments of science between hopes and hazards is what we read in books and what we practice through missionaries. So that's why it may be a little bit boresome or monotonous, but still it is an unavoidable way of commencing any lecture. The first thing is analytical knowledge. Any person, analytical knowledge comes from fear. For example, any animal on seeing something which is changed, decomposed or disposed or deformed, immediately it smells. So it is known as the inceptive stage of analysis. Analysis means it does not require a lab and all of other equipments. It does not mean so. So analysis is assurance of whether to take it or to leave it. So starting from the biosecurity instinct of animals, analysis started. Even we start with analysis because whether to take it or not, whether that is reliable or not, that is the initial instinct for analysis. And those things are good. I have taught a mantra at our astro-spiritual retreat campaign, that is sukshma, dura, ghuta, sthula. Even in tangible things, there will be hidden portions. Even in visible things, there will be invisible things. That is known as sthula. Sukshma, so many things will be very subtle so that they are not visible. Gudha, something will be hidden so that it cannot be seen, that is concealed. And the other thing is known as Gupta. It is available, but its characteristics are being curtained, and somebody has to tear the unveiling process, somebody has to tear the curtain and get the reality of the, what is what we call photorealism in a computer system of graphics, that you say. The realistic structure, the veritable mode of the picture can be envisioned only by that project. Then the thing is Gudha, Gupta, Sthula and Sukshma. So all of these things can be seen only by an analytical view on different grades. For example, to get into mining is different from water digging. To get into fishing is different from a coral dive. It is not this type of coral or pearl dive. That is a coral dive or a pearl dive. There will be lot of coral considerations and consolidations of pearls in the abysmal oceans. It is not a dive but dive. So depending upon the depth, we have to reach a lot of destinations for understanding these things. So the analytical portion of the brain, the analytical portion of the brain deals with evaluation of objects, their inner subtleties, their possibilities in reaction, their utility and services. So the nature, the behavior, reaction and application, these four things are understood in analysis. The second thing is creativity, by analyzing a particular thing to make a model which is a cognitive model, which is a psycho-based model, which is an internal model, which is a memory-oriented model, or which is a subtle model, which is an impalpable self-inconstructed model, that is known as creativity. So analytical knowledge evaluates the things as per their nation, function, behavior, reaction and purpose. So the second thing, advanced creativity, after analyzing, bringing out a real form or a structure or model mind, is known as creativity. Technical knowledge is bringing the same thing by making a compound of various components which can do collectively or integrally the job which you want to do that. You follow that? If you want to grind by your creativity, then it is implemented in a grinder. So it has all the components, a motor, a connective motor sheath, and also some sort of external things that are required as a holder, as a roller, as a constant. Everything is required for that. So a machine as well as the accessories for the machine, that is designed in technical knowledges. So analysis or analytical knowledge is initial, which leads to creative knowledge. Creative knowledge is just practically personified in the form of a device which is known as technical knowledge. So any science, especially graphics, especially image-oriented science and sound processing techniques, they are based on analysis, tonal analysis, gradual analysis, generic analysis, spatial analysis, subtlety analysis, tone analysis, then order analysis, multiple analysis. All of these analytical studies are being done. Then they are processed into a model in our mind in the form of our creativity. Then the model, the same model, is executed in the form of a machine. And that machine has all components for handling each and every action that is required for the composite effect of the desirous thing. So these three things are Shakti Trikam. are Trayi. They are known as Trayi. These three Shaktis are very much essential. And no book, that's what I told yesterday, all of your books, classrooms and your parents as well as the teacher, they don't create any motivation for spirit, for learning, for getting into learning or for mastering your learning and applications. They just create an atmosphere or a compulsion and thrust upon you to learn. Yes, you have to learn, tomorrow is examination. So it is a compulsion, it is a coercive process. And yesterday I told four major components of education. One is the depth. Second thing is understanding. Then third thing is joy or comfort or peace. The fourth thing is usage or service or utility to the society. Four things are not there in modern education. There is no depth in the syllabus. The syllabus is totally unupgraded in Indian syllabi. The second thing is there is no understanding at all. Somehow we are compelled to impose all of these things inside and or vomit at the time of any unentertaining examinations or interviews. Then the third thing is joy. There is no joy at all. Whenever you come out of the school, then only you will joy. The fourth thing is, yes, that is not an entry joy. That is an exit joy. Then the fourth thing is usage. What is the usage for this society? Except few people learning and few people earning and munching the money and then elaborating their fantasy, comfortability and luxury without having proper way of understanding. That is mortgaging their harmony, peace, happiness and other valuable instincts, they are getting some money and they feel for it at a later time whether that is useful or not. They are starting to realize it at a time where the realizing mentality itself is going on fading. So it is practicing Surya Namaskara after optical nervous burst. So these three types of Shaktis, to produce these Shaktis, is there, I can ask all of you, have you learned, have you heard any exercise, mental, it need not be religious, any mental or intellectual exercise, even it may be a very initial step to develop creative intelligence, what is the first step? Can anybody say that? To read books or all of these things are there, very common. So books are there as an additive material for your inner thing. For example, if you are not having your optic scope or optoscope, your natural eyes, what will be the use of microscope, telescope, infrascope, ultrascope and abiscope for you? It is a subjective and supportive tool for your natural eyes. If that is not there, what is the use of all of these spectacles? Useless. Likewise, there is an inbuilt zeal for that. Now I am going to present in the most possible, digestible and palatable manner by which you can create enthusiasm. That's what I told yesterday. Each and every seminar or conference is meant for giving information and inducing enthusiasm. Then according to your fortune, fate and destiny, you have to proceed and get those things. So this Shakti Trakam or the Shakti Trayi, we used to call the compound as Trayi. That is the basic need for any person to have independent, semi-dependent and operative intelligence. What is independent intelligence? Without the help of any processing of machines, we can do something. See, there are two things. One is processing, second thing is distribution or transfer. Regarding distribution, that's why I say, it is an ambivalent industry in which your intelligence and artificial intelligence should coexist. I don't deny that at all, because that is very much useful for distribution and reach. For example, you can create a wonderful thing by your independent intelligence. To make it reach 1 lakh of people, there is no tool within human intelligence. You can compose a graphical still or a graphical series or sequences. To reach immediately with rapidity, with multiplicity, with multitude, to reach that in each and every nook and corner of the society, we have to take use of that. So creativity is the portion of human intelligence and distribution and reach is the portion of modern artificial intelligence. This is a reasonable and healthy combination. Depending on the computers as well as the systems and softwares for even creativity, that will give you only operative intelligence. Later on, your generations and yourself by means of instantaneous and genetic erosion and loss, you will lose your natural creative intelligence. So this is a healthy combination of machines for distribution and human intelligence for consumption. If you use machines for consumption, you will be totally lost. Can anybody draw a line straightly like that? No. Because there is a computer-led drawing system wherein by even if the position is deviated, it straightens by itself. There is an automation system. There is a system of, that is called automation or auto-rectification. Whatever you want to draw and however you want to put it, it rectifies, it leads, it supports, it guides, and it symbolically, it just creates a view and form of what you want to do. So your intention is given a form with additional artificial intelligence support. Can anybody with AutoCAD and CAD industrial attach and usage, those people, they cannot draw even a small line without any failure. Unless they have some inbuilt intelligence. Because everything, making a circle, making a curvature, to make a parabolic substance, to make something elliptical, to make a cube, to make a cone, to make a sphere, to make a prism, to make a tube, to make a cylinder, everything is there in human vision. And also it is known of extensive imaging of forms by means of our brain mapping. This skill is totally lost because of this AutoCAD. This is a blessing of AutoCAD, that the natural drawing system inside your mind totally faded. After 2 decades, there won't be any person to draw. He will draw himself for drawing, but he won't go for draw. So these things come from 3 major tools of human beings. The first is the mind tool, second is the brain tool, third is the machine tool. What is brain and what is mind and what is machine? There are 2 types of machines, and I want to put it in a very as well as an analytical system. Mind is a subtle tool for subtle energetic emissions. Brain is a tangible tool for subtle operative emissions. There are 2 types of machines. The first phase of machines were tangible tools for tangible energy emissions or tangible operation emissions. Now we are having machines for tangible mode. They are meant for subtle modes of emissions. And I think that I have to still explain it. Mind. What is subtle? That which is beyond the reach of our senses, like vision, audition, touch, olfaction and taste. These are all the basic senses. That which cannot be graspable by any senses, that is known as subtle. So mind is subtle because we cannot, that is, it is subjected to unintelligibility and unscrutability. It is imperceptible in nature, that's why it is called as subtle. So mind is subtle beyond our senses, and all the operations of mind, that is also. Brain is tangible. You are having imaging, mapping, everything. So it is a tangible substance. It is a tangible, symmetrical, vegetative stuff. And it is having all the subtle governance of your actions. That is the second level. The third level of machines, all the machines are tangible. You know that all the machines are tangible. And all these machines are governing the tangible actions of human being, the first era. Now in the present era, they are doing all the subtle things like intelligence, like data preservation, security, analytical study, for transcription, translation, and even in neuroprosthetics, we are having for thinking, memory boosting. There is brain port, there is brain reload, brain upload, brain comload, cognitive transfer, whole body transplant. Everything is there in modern neuroprosthetics. So now the science is having the possibility of having a tangible tool to make subtle operations. So this is the definition for machines. First of all, we must identify these 3 major tools. One is a human being having 3 extension. One is the extension through mind, second is the extension through brain, third is the extension through mechanics or machines. Very fundamentals of reading graphics. The second thing is, I want to say that there are 2 dhatus. I don't know why I have been given the opportunity of dealing with this 2 dhatus simultaneously in the same city of Pune. Yesterday the topic was about Sanskrit language. Today I have been describing about 3 things: acoustic, phonetics and linguistics. Shabda Vidya or sound is known as acoustics. Varna Uchharana Vidya, when the Shabda sound becomes vowels and consonants, then it becomes phonetics. When the same thing group and summarize and they conglomerate to form a language or a system of adoption of communication, then it becomes Bhasha Shastra, which is known as linguistics. Studying the descriptive way of linguistics as per its order is known as philology. Then there is semantics, etymology, syntax, lexicography, innumerable things are there. All of these things are coming from Shabda Dhatu. The Dhatu is known as Shabda Dhatu. And day before yesterday also we've been talking about mantras. That is also science that is related to Shabda, the Dhatu of Shabda. And the second is Rupa Dhatu. Yesterday and day before yesterday we discussed about Shabda Dhatu. And Rupa Dhatu is the basic formation for graphics. It is known as that is known as voxel. The scientific terms for scientific term for Shabda Dhatu and Rupa Dhatu is voxel and pixel. And the energy particle that releases this dhatu, that primordial substance, is known as phonon and photon. The basic inhibitive energy emissions that comes from phonon which develops into a voxel, which is the basic unit or dot sound. The same thing, phonon for light, which comes in the form of pixel. What is the use of understanding this thing? Whenever a person, that's what I told in that lecture, our human intelligence or cognitive area is like a beehive. It consists of innumerable chambers. By knowing each and everything, each chamber will be opened so that the respiration or that the transfer and transmission of energy particles inside the body will be very much broadened. You can easily learn things. Number two, you can understand and relish all things known to you. Number two, without even being instructed or informed, you can understand lot of things by yourself. So why we have to understand the basics of knowledge and purpose of knowledge? Because your chambers of knowledge is a hive. It consists of compartments, apartments and departments. These things, while if you broaden both your enthusiasm, capability and approach for learning more, immediately those things are totally congestions, that blocks and that unwanted dirt that is accumulated inside, everything is cleansed and cleared, so that the pathway becomes very easy. You rotate and circulate that energy into various other forms. That is why karanam tu dhyayaha, so says the Upanishad. If you really meditate the karana, understand the karana or the purpose of the causative factor of any faculty, then immediately three things will be broadened. One thing is enthusiasm to learn, broader view of the learned things with more apprehension and more rejoicement. Third thing, automatic stimulation. Stimulation and simulation, there are two skills. Simulation is a graphical skill, and that graphy is known as photography, that starts with light. And this is psychography, it is on based of stimulation. That is simulation processing, this is stimulation processing. And it will make you to get inner stimulation of understanding things that have not been informed and instructed to you. These three skills are the purposes of understanding these benefits. So, Shabda and Rupa. What is Shabda and Rupa? Both the things are interconvertible. According to Shastras, Shabda only created light, and light can be transferred or convertible into sound. It is not there in modern science. It may take few decades. Shabda and Rupa, they meet at one phase. If the meeting point is known, any light can have its own, any light is having its own sound. And sound particles are having their own light intensity. But both the things are very infinitesimal and they are in impalpable dimension. So this is the way of understanding Shabda and Rupa. And understanding Shabda and Rupa, first we have to understand what is Rupa. Rupa is a form. Rupa is a form. And form means innumerable forms are there. We are seeing innumerable forms. Each and every form has its own description. How to bring them into a practical way of system understanding. That is known as graphics. So, graph is the construction model of anything. And graphy is the science which deals with the construction model. Construction model is graphy, and constructing the models is graphics. So, it has our participation. So, this Rupa or this form, that is the basic exercise. I am going to give five major exercises for getting more creativity and hyper rapid performance later as the epilogue of today's function. I want to say, in Acharya Anugraha, there are four methodologies. One is Ajna. Second thing is Prerana. How to do that Prerana. The third thing is Anupravesha. All the things are there in modern graphics. The same thing is there in modern graphics. What we have in the form of Ajna is known as voice command. And what we are having in the form of Prerana is known as mouse manipulation. And what we call text loading or text entry is known as Anupravesha. So like that, each and every basic thing that we see, there had been an earlier model in subtle physics. The same thing which we are going to implement here, if that subtlety is understood, then handling these things would have been more easy. Without any risk, without any perspiration or exertion, you can do it as an enjoyable job. That is the greatness of that. So we have a lot of things, even before whatever we are calling by shock waves, MPEG, etc. The same, the first initial model of graphics is by seeing the pictures, one understanding them. How? Achala and Chala. How many parinamas are there? Achala and Chala. Shabda is having Achala and Chala. And Rupa is having Achala and Chala. For example, there is a sound. Sound, is sound a mobile or immobile factor? Shravana and Darshana. Chala and Achala. You have to understand this very basically. Darshana is seeing an object. Seeing an object, it is moving. You cannot hold. There will be movement. You can just command a person or you can without blinking see that. That is an informal exercise. Normally, things are moving. And sound, naturally, it passes through waves. Isn't it so? So they are known as chala. So to make them achala, the mechanical processes came into existence. For example, if you take a person and if you see the person, that is known as chala, that is real. And if you take a photography, that photography is known as achala, that is standard. Likewise, sound also, if you hear somebody, that is chala. If you record this, that becomes achala. So, chala is a natural process of sound and visual experiences. And achala is a process by which this darshana and shravana, that has become a new scientific method that has made it to become an entry into grahana. Grahana, how to captivate sound and how to captivate visuals. That is known as photography. And even in photography, you have chala and achala, still photography and video photography. Even in sound, for means of phono processing and understanding, each and every syllable can be just instilled in its own standard for understanding resonance, pitch, tone and scale. It is sound processing. We can make it achala. Then if you just make it run, it is known as chala. So there are different processes of expansion by which visual experience becomes photography, photography becomes videography. And our additional experience that become recording, recording becomes phono processing, which is there known as phonologic or volume logic. We used to have that, phonometry. So this is the process of expansion of all of these things. It is a basic unit for expansion of all of these things. And there are innumerable divisions for all of these things also. We have to start with three systems of action. One is inaction, second is action, third is interaction. And this can be even compared with linear and non-linear systems of operations. Linear is a system which just plays or runs with its own schedule. And anything that is subjected to operation, optional drive and intrusion, that is known as non-linear. That comes in interactive way of learning. Our interactive systems like TVs or interactive computer graphics is there. And Dr. Ivan Sutherland is the father or grandfather of this computer graphical user interfaces as well as interactive computer graphics. Dr. Ivan Sutherland is the father. So this is the development of science. Inaction, action and interaction. What is inaction? What is action? If I am seeing a person, that is action. If I am grasping a person's photo, that is inaction. That has no mode at all. If I am seeing, that is action. If the same thing is processed with mutuality, whereby we can interfere. Now there is music, interactive music. Somebody will sing. You can also shout with them. Then there is going to be interactive cinemas after 10 years. In which you can, by means of your visual projection, you can jump and you can fight with the hero, you can fight with the villain, you can kidnap the heroine or do anything as per your wish. Nobody has imagined, I think. So after 10 years, you can just note down, there will be an interactive cine system, wherein by you can see your favorite movie and you can act also, without getting money or paying money to the director and producer. So now we are in the interactive system. With each and every module which cannot be governed because of reasons of distance. Number one is reasons of distance. Second is mode variation. Something is in a pictorial mode, something is in a real mode, that is image mode. whatever that is appearing in the TV is in image mode and you are in the real mode. How there can be a common principle focus between a real and image mode? There can be reflection. How they can be interaction between a real and imaginary sensation? It is very impossible. Even by virtual imaging and by means of interactive graphical modules, there will be a possibility in which you can participate with any person at all. So now we are going to study about the graphics and graphic siddhis. According to Shastras, there is a process known as conogenesis. Whenever you want to create a particular person, known as metagenesis and even conogenesis. From sankalpa, if you do, just by mere wish and desire, if somebody can create a person, that is known as conogenesis. Somebody out of their fruitful austerity and potential will and command, they could create somebody, that is known as metagenesis. And these things are fictional and we used to read the stories about great seers, but the same thing has been made available in a mechanical dimension. Now you can create any person. So the history of graphics, it does start with the first show which was conducted, the explosive plastic unavoidable, 1965. That was the first show where the multimedia was started. What is multimedia and what is medium? Medium is any source of connectivity between the learner and teacher. Medium can be a language. In school, medium is a language. Which medium to belong means you must not say something else. That is English or Hindi medium or something. And in parapsychology, a person who communicates with a ghost and a living person, he is said to be a medium. And he must not be qualified as an English medium or Hindi medium. That medium is different. That is a subtle medium. Then the third thing, Acharya is a medium or mediator between two persons. One is God and second is a devotee. And there is mediation in the form of reconciliation, articulation, arbitration. Technologies are available between the international issues and international disputes. So medium means any tool which connects two people. What are the two tools? One, a learner. Second is subjects for learning. So anything that connects the subjects of learning to the real person who wanted to learn is known as medium. Why it is known as media? Media is different, multimedia is different. Why it is known as media? Because it covers all subjects. It is known as multimedia because it covers all systems of tools. All systems of tools are covered. What is multimedia? One, text. The sound is reproduced in the form of letters. Achala chala, I told na. If you say I want to go, you cannot captivate I want to go in the form of sound. Even if you record that sound, that will go away. That will move away, isn't it so? Sound is passing. So without passing, there must be a standard copy or caging of the message I want to go. The only way is orthography. Recording through sound is known as phonography. Implementing the same thing to letters is known as orthography. So it is known as ortho caging, that is known as phono caging, in which captivation of sound is made. So the first level of multimedia is text. Second is text with sound. Third thing is text with sound with images. Text with sound with image with graphics. Text with sound with only images. Text with sound with a lively person who is demonstrating all of these things. Then audio visual, just sound and video without text. These are all the various expansions of multimedia. Medium is the connectivity between learner and lot of things to learn. And media is lot of subjects, multi-versatile in stages, which are going to be covered. And multi is a prefix which gives the idea that it can give a text or text with sound or with graphics or sound with image, image with the text with the sound, or even a lively person with all the available propositions. So that is why it is known as multimedia. Sadhana Vaividya. This is the definition for multimedia. And in our Shastras, we did have our own multimedia. That is Shabda Grahana, Rupa Grahana, Shabda Rupa Grahana, Dvani Grahana, Akshara Siddhi. We used to have a lot of Siddhis like that, the same thing. Akshara Siddhi or Akshara Abhyasa, you see, Karna, Jihva Lekana and Akshara Abhyasa are three samskaras. Akshara Lekana, by catching hold of the hands of the disciple or a small boy with a tender age, the master will write. He will initiate the process of writing. That is Akshara Abhyasa. Jihva Lekana is writing in the tongue. Karna Bodha is sound initiation. So sound initiation, exposition initiation and orthographic initiation is done in our samskaras. With mantras, anybody can catch hold of anybody's hand and write anything at all if the other person is a fool and flexible. So that is another thing. Writing with mantra, initiating a proposition or initiating a potential journey which empowers the person to have multi-level grasping, multi-depth level grasping, multi-gradular and multi-generic grasping in sound and in oration and in orthography is given as a boon and blessing to those people who existed. So these three things are very much essential. These things we can even say that they are onto multimedia skill development techniques, Akshara Abhyasa, Jihva Lekana and Karna Bodha. These things are, they form the very base things. Unless you have these skills, what is the use of the machines with you? You will be a slave and servant to the machines. It is your individuality by which you can escape from the addiction to a machine, radiation to the machine, toxic emulsion of the machine, and the electrical emulsion of the machine. There are four great hazards of the machine. The one is toxic emission, second is radiation, third thing is electronic emulsion, fourth thing is addiction and dependence. So before getting into machines, I destiny you work with the machine, you embrace the machine, hug it and cry it with for 10 hours, but at least 1 hour try to meditate and do something to develop or to make blossom your natural non-mechanical or super mechanical skills by which you can teach the machine at all. The history does not start with, I've already told, this explosive plastic, unavoidably is the first show. Then there were slideshow projectors. Now only recently in the 1990s we started with CD-ROM devices for getting, storing the data of sound and images. Now we are having innumerable things now. We can just think of those things. Those things are available in the history and something. We want to say and see something that is behind and beyond the surface of your learning to make the already existing learning very productive. Now let me come to the major systems that are existing now, the major utility or utilization services. What are the purposes of human civilization? In expansion of human civilization, they used to talk more, they used to talk with many, they used to talk with people many times on many occasions who are dwelling in many areas. Many areas, many things, many times, many persons. So we want to have basic a system for development. We want whatever we have as a concept, we want to develop it. So develop a system, detail a system, process a system, communicate a system, transfer a system, security and privacy of the system, then edit the system, publish the system, then videography and audiography, and there is a intrusive videography or intrusive drawing or inclusive drawing. Now it is a coral paint, it is an example for intrusive drawing. Like Brahma, you can play with people, you can put four hands, you can make the clumsy nose, you can do anything. Just as God is playing with human beings, you can play with images. That is coral paint. So all of these things, they start from the creativity of drawing. So I want to now teach you the drawing, especially it will take, because Chitra Shastra, you won't believe, there is a compendium of Chitra Shastra in Malayala language, which is available only in manuscripts. It comes up to 6,000 pages. It is there at an Kalpathi Agraha. How great it would have been if it had been published and if it had been channelized for the modern people to understand these things. What is a drawing? First of all, there is a system inside our mind known as Sankalana Siddhi or assembly. And anybody poor in graphics, anybody struggling in some graphical exercises, certainly they have to note down these mantras, practice it and give the progress report to Bhakkarji or the institution or administration, how the progress is working. Without knowing how it is working, I have been just making somebody talk, it is a verbal dysentery. So continuously we have been talking on various practical occasions. If I am inviting you for a feast with just tables and talking about all food dirty items, food materials, process of cooking, their delicious taste, their order, everything, etc. Is that your productive exercise? Inviting you all for a lunch and making you and instructing you not to eat anything since your morning. I am asking all of you to assemble and attend an auditorium. Then I am not talking anything. I am saying about, oh, how great that kachodi was yesterday. It was just a hydropower station in my mouth yesterday. Because it is a practical science. So what are all the graphical skills I will enlist? Where you are struggling, where you are suffocating, where you are sensitive, where you are hypersensitive, where you are successful, five areas are there. Sensitivity is the response. Hypersensitivity is very casual response. Success is uniqueness inside you, and suffocation is very difficult. Struggling is you can do, but there is risk. These five methodologies are there in graphic theory. These are in all sciences. Even you take chemistry, even you take Japanese language or English or Sanskrit, these five things are very common in any system of learning. You have to tabulate, and wherever you see, you have to adapt my exercises and say that you have developed or you have been furthermore made worse. Whatever it may be, any beneficial or beneficial output that must be given for our further record and experiments are more people like you later. So it starts with the system of assembly. What is assembly? You are having a spark that is known as scintillant. Whenever you think of something to speak, it starts with only a scintillant. For example, I say I welcome everybody. That is a small instinct. I want to welcome everybody is a lengthy sentence, but my wish to welcome everybody is a small dot. Do you follow that? That is known as scintillant. Yesterday I told it is known as psychoron, not psychotron. It is psychoron. Like positron, photon and phonon, it is a psychoron. It is a basic tool or a subatomic nuclei of the mind in which I want to say that I welcome you all. So the thought will not be as lengthy as the statement. That immediate dot, then that develops into who wants, to whom, to do what, on what grounds. I want, to is a preposition, welcome all. I is the karta, the person does. Want is my desire or wish. Welcoming is my act. To is a conjunction or preposition. All is a specific explanation of you all. You is the object. And all is a specific elucidation of the object. And this process, while explaining, it takes two sentences, and to say it takes one sentence, but it is a fraction of a picosecond for developing that psychoron or that. You follow that? It is known as assembly. In your mind, whenever you think a sentence, immediately that thing, immediately within a fraction of picosecond, I told, it translates, transforms and transfigures the whole statement. Even if I want to talk on graphics for 40 minutes, the whole 40 minutes, each and every sentence or concept, it will have the basic scintillant. For all the totalitarian view, there will be a common basic root scintillant. Works if we think immediately, that common scintillant that will rise, that is known as primeval scintillant. Then it will become processive scintillant or scintillant of various stages. Then they will be differentiated into phrases, then into sentences, then into words, then into syllabi. This is the real way. It is known as assembly. Either in speech or in writing or in other things, it is very much useful. It is known as assembly. There are two types of assembly. One is a gradual assembly and second is a spontaneous assembly. Persons, for example, poetry, it has a process. If you want to write a poem, there is a process. You cannot say anything like that. So it requires the style of presentation, the rhythm of words, number of letters or number of words in the verse, everything is must be very systematic and calculative. So a person, unless he takes some time inside or outside, he works out in a paper, he cannot do that. That is known as processive assembly or gradual assembly. And persons, immediately they can write poems. Immediately they can write poems. And writing takes more time than narration. Some people are there who can narrate poems immediately. They are known as Ashukavis. Immediately they can do that. So there are some people who are having spontaneous flow of assembly. Assembly is a gradual process. You have to take the brick of each and every portion of your language, your subject and methodology order of presentation. There are three bricks in construction of speech, in drawing and in writing. There are three bricks, basic units. One is a lingual brick. Second is a conceptive brick. There is a brick of the substance. Third thing is the order or style or methodology, or it is known as method brick. The brick of a method of speech, the brick of the language of speech, the brick of the subject or the faculty or discipline of speech. So it is a discipline brick, it is a language brick, and it is a method brick. So while a person is speaking, if he wants to be a real winner in his oration and narration with super eloquation and torrential shower of uniformity and integrity between these three things, certainly he must have that assembly inbuilt within himself. Isn't it so? So this person must govern the language, the grammar and the structure of a phrase making along with the subject and continuity of the subject, phraseology must be very much attractive to the people and productive to them. So assembly is the process of getting the basic bricks assembled inside, which is known as Medha Siddhi. Medha Siddhi in multiversity, one lecture I want to say, there are 1826 Siddhis or expansions of Medhas, in which assembly is one among the Siddhi, 1826. And then assembly, I have told two types of assembly. Third thing I am going to tell about extension. What is extension? You are speaking. Speaking is an initial exercise. What may be the extension of speech? Song may be the extension of a speech, or poetry may be the extension of a speech. Multilingualism may be the extension of a speech, isn't it so? It is a decorative extension. Likewise, writing is the initial exercise of your hand, and drawing is the secondary extension of your skill. So, speech extends into song, poetry, and multilingualism, and writing exercise that extends into drawing. And drawing, what are the types of drawing? Yantra Chitra, in Sanskrit it will take some time. One is mechanical drawing, second is subspecial drawing, third is natural drawing, fourth is personal drawing. There's a lot of drawings are there, are you know? One is machine drawing, second is subspecial drawing, third thing is natural drawing, fourth thing is personal drawing, these things. Fifth thing is construction drawing, sixth thing is scape drawing or landscape drawing, that is available now. All of these things are major schools of drawing, and drawing requires four skills inside you, and there are four small mantras for that. Very small mantra. Somebody should practice it or at least experiment it. One is observation based drawing, second is memory based drawing, third is copying or imitating drawing, fourth thing is imaginary or speculative drawing. You can draw something out of your imagination, you can draw something by observation, you can draw something by your already existing observation, that is known as memory. Already there is a drawn substance by which you can copy it. These are all the four skills of drawing. And there are also some more four types of drawing. The first type of drawing is resemblant drawing. Four types. First is resemblant, second is identical, third thing is adumbrate, and fourth thing is pigmatic or cacophonic. Identical is exactly drawing a person like that. That is known as identical. You might have seen, for example, if you are drawing exactly a person, let us take the Pandavas, the movie. If you are exactly drawing the person, that is known as identical. That is with cinema. That is the exact person. If the same thing is reproduced, it is very difficult in mechanical reproduction, the same thing. It is difficult because it takes more time, more persons, and it is very costly. To call a person and ask the person to come and sit in your throne and to keep the hand like this, it is enough if you give him 500 rupees. But if you want to make the same thing in graphics with identical representation, it will cost 5 lakhs. Who will prefer that? Really, I am saying, it is very costly. The second thing is resemblant. You have seen Pandavas. That was not like animation, exact animation. And that is something like a resemblance structure of human beings with the physical form, everything, etc. That is the second level of graphics. And the third level of thing, that is known as adumbrate. Adumbrate drawing is there. See, put a form like this, and if you fix a glass like this, then that is Gandhiji. That is adumbrate. Now you can see that with the turban or with glass or any specification, if you put a small thing, that is known as adumbrate drawing. That person must be a familiar, popular, and also a super popular person in the society. If you just put two or three lines, nobody can interpret it. The person must be well known to the society. That is adumbrate. And fourth thing is, you have seen in Tinkle Digest, Amar Chitra Gata, there will be Krishna, Rama, it will be quixotic. It will not be resemblant, it is not a quixotic drawing. Or multi-line drawing, it means the outline will be there. These are all the various styles of drawing that we possess. And even in drawing has now, it has become technical drawing. It is drawing technology now, because it started only with drawing, then it became painting, then it became printing, then it became outline. Now we are having innumerable things. It started with only drawing. Now we are having innumerable things like illustration, diagram, graph, geometry, then web-based graphics and computer-based graphics. So starting from the drawing industry, the technical extension of the drawing industry is what we call now the graphics, modern graphics inside. So the graphics, you know that there are two types of system. Brahma used to create the prapancha and the form of two things. One is by the composition of Rupa Dhatu. Second, while fixing the structure of a person, he undergoes a mathematical way or a format which is known as vector graphics now. So the mathematical formation of a person's outline and also the Rupa Dhatu formation, pixel formation, that is really known as the two major schools of graphics which is there in the science of creation itself. So on the basis of thing, what are all the things that can be Brahma, whatever he says in the Sritti Veda or whatever there in Ashtama Siddhi, which is known as Prakamya, everything is there in graphics, I want to say. Number one, disappearance or Tirodhana, emergence or Utpatti, it is emergence, dimensional variation, expansion, merging, submergences, then multiple vision, distant vision, magnified vision, subtle vision, miniaturization, hyper magnification, what we are having in the graphical skills to present in movies or to present in ads or to present in mechanical education services. Various things are there for graphics. It starts with a commercial process. It has also triple E. Graphics has also got a triple E. Education, entertainment and engineering utilities. So it is useful in even medicine, even in science, various areas they are using. And for everything, there is something which is forming the base of graphics. Dashakriya, unless you write the Dashakriya, note down the Dashakriya, you cannot understand. Create something which is not there, that is known as visual imaging. Create something which is there in a different form. How visual surgery is done in surgical theatres, visual imaging of the heart and brain for understanding the nuances of operations and to exactly do things precise. Then merging one with other. Submerging a component in a big compound. Extension of structure or function. Rupa or gati of objects or images. Magnification or mahima. Miniaturization or anima. Multiplication. You know that the movie, They have shown one traffic jam of more than 1,000 vehicles. The Tamil movie, through graphics. So it is multiplication. So each and everything, the basic Rupa Dhatu that is constructed in form of assembly. First is constructive assembly. Second is a dot assembly into the form and multiplication. The same thing was there when Krishna multiplied himself in Rasa Leela to several people. That is something mythological. The same thing is mechanical. Practically envisioned barriers in various things. So to create something, to deform something, reform something, to superform something, to disperse something, to disappear something, for all of these dashakriyas, the major skill that is used is the inner power or power of creation. Now the same thing with mechanical substitute, it is done with creativity. There are innumerable graphics, the systems of graphics also innumerable. Like even we used to say shading and ray tracing. I explained in cosmogenesis what is known as shading and ray tracing, which is there in modern graphics. Likewise, only we can imitate a greater process. Each and every invention, there are two processes. One is mega process or greater process, and second is the repetitive process or imitative process. So that is known as ontomimetics. What is that science known as? Ontomimetics. Living beings, lot of living beings, they have lot of behavior. If you adopt the same behavior, like understanding the structure of the abysmal species known as fishes, whales and etc. to construct ships as well as submerging machines, understanding the behaviors of the aves community like birds, and understanding aerodynamics and constructing airplanes etc. These things are the forms of biomimetics. Likewise, understanding the earth's behavior, climatic seasonal behavior, and creating our own environment is known as geomimetics. Likewise, understanding the work of God and to represent the work of God within our limited ambit is known as ontomimetics. Graphics is a creativity which is an ontomimetic skill of the God's work. So that is known as ontographics, and there is metagraphics, mechagraphics. Now there is a silica graphics is there, and new micrographics is there, drawing the subtleties of element, that is known as micrographics. Innumerable systems of graphics, they are going to come, and they are available now. So finally concluding the session, I want to say that five exercises. The first exercise is the grand design model. If you understand and contemplate the grand design model of the universe, then with any machine, without any machine, you can have independent, individual and distinguishable, distinct creativity and performance skill. That is grand design model exercise. How to make that exercise? For that you have to understand spatial and spatial evolution, how you have formed and what is the beauty of the universe. The person loves nature, the person who realizes and relishes the nature, the person who meditates and worships the nature, he gets more creativity. That is grand design model. He must be happy with three things. One is creator God, second is the creation nature, third is the creature's fellow human beings, animals and birds. The love towards all of these things will create automatically lot of instinctive valor and vigor to do more creativity. And I am not doing that yet, I am a good creative person. Means you must have done it earlier in your previous samskaras. Without doing that, how it will come? How suddenly the bank will have lakhs of rupees unless you have deposited in your previous months or years. How you can see lakhs of rupees in your bank balance? Likewise, this thing is nothing but a composition of your previous accumulations. So grand design model, I think that Samir or somebody should follow. What is grand design model? What are all the exercises? Immediately you have to take a printout and give to them. Grand design model itself, it will take half an hour to explain. So the names are given to love nature, to love God and love human beings. Somebody will be having over love towards God. Somebody will be with nature, immersed with nature. Somebody will be immersed with living beings, somebody pets, somebody with microbes. Various tastes are there in the society. So that is grand design model. And second thing is creative meditation. Daily for 25 minutes at least, you have to do that creative meditation. What is it? What are the benefits of creative meditation? It is really something wondrous. One thing, it will induce your creativity. One, it will reduce the stress which is produced while your creativity. Third thing, it will reduce the negativity that is developed in the course of your creativity. Whenever you are doing useless work, the work we used to say, there are different types of reflections. Six reflections are there in Shastras. One is wonder, Ascharya. Second is attraction or Akarshana. Third thing is inspiration. I am inspired by this portrait. The portrait is wondrous. It is very attractive. So a lot of these instincts are there. The real instinct which is required is life. That is Jivana. It must have Jeev inside. So you can create wonder. Wonderful people, they can create wonder. And beautiful designing that can create attraction. That which is with a volume and message and velocity that can give you some sort of inspiration can also be produced by people. And the fourth thing is commercial value. That is marketability. And fifth thing is very humorous. It is ambiguity. If you cannot understand anything from a portrait, that becomes a real craze value. If you see something, and they will think that if we admit that we cannot realize everything, then we will be totally discarded by the society as unworthy for relishing modern art. So due to fear, if somebody just scribbles like this, 1, 2, 3, how is this? Very wonderful. Why? Because if you don't relish it, they will think that you are not suitable for modern age. Go to the stone age or copper age. That is out to ambiguity and obscurity. So there are six values. One is the value of wonder. Second is the value of attraction. Third is the value of inspiration. Fourth is commercialization. Fifth is ambiguity and obscurity. Sixth is life. Only person with divine hand can produce life. Then everybody is enjoying a lot of things. That might be wonder, attraction or inspiration, not life. Somebody told that it was having life. It must have been told by a lifeless person that it had life. So for that only, the creative meditation is a very good exercise. With the help of God or without thinking God, with thinking the splendor of the world, thinking about truth, you have to go in meditation, maybe in the language of even English and your natural language. Mantras are not immediately assimilable by people. So we can have creative meditation. So, but we can say that let my inbuilt immense creative power, let it blossom. Each and everything, I find it to be very perfect and precise and systematic. I am the only person imperfect and imprecise in the world. I am very much taken aback. I was very much moved by knowing the subtlety of each and every element or ingredient that I see and move with. And my mentality or my frequency mismatch that prevents me from getting the reality, the photorealism I already told. The photorealism or the conceptive realism or the message realism, totally due to your frequency mismatch, I am not able to relish it. Let my inner power, let my inner will, let it induce me so that I can start loving things. Starting loving things make you to know things. Knowing things make you to hold the things. Holding the things make you to produce things. Producing the things give you to reproduce the things. Just reproducing the things make you to do innovative measures in remodeling and re-embellishing their natural beauty and taste and splendor. That is the greatness. So we are only having hexagonal graphics. What is it known as? Hexagonal graphics. First, the graphics was only with picture. Second, slideshow projection, they used to narrate. Then they mixed sound. Then it was bisensory. Later, now they are researching for trisensory. That is known as haptics. Have you heard of the word haptics? Yes. Haptics is an environment in graphics where you can see, hear and also feel. Like tridimensional, we can feel the proximity, the involvement, your presence, participation, and the reality of your connectivity can be felt in that. That is known as haptics. Now they are trying to bring two more things, smell and taste. If that thing comes, nobody for eating. At least they are going for eating, being the focus, isn't it so? So that is natural. Sound, is somebody going to throw sound on you? Sound is also, naturally it passes. Image does not pass, but it is reflected. So reflection is the criterion for optical vision. And transmission is for sound. You follow that? Then feeling, sensory perception is also by means of transmission. As that transmission is not there within the two-dimensional audio-visual things, now they have developed these haptics. By means of haptics is also not just a sensory feeling. That is psychosensory feeling. For example, if you see somebody suffering, you are crying. That is psychosensory. But if you are pierced with a needle by your beloved friend or enemy, then you are feeling. that is physical sensory feeling. And crying after seeing movies, either for the scene or for having paid that much of money for that movie, that is a psychosensory feeling. Only our ontographics, we can create the other three senses. Haptics, we can create only a resemblance. Now they are trying to bring the other two senses. But in the creative meditation, we can take care of the five things. Panchendriya Nyasa or Samyama. So, just think about all the beautiful things you have seen. Just immediate exercises. If you see that creative intelligence, the methodology, everybody will be very happy. You will feel that they are blessed and blissful. Hear all good things. Try to hear in meditation all the good things that you have heard. That will improve your sensitivity to make good sounds and to create clear pictures, pictures with more depth. There is a depth in three-dimensional graphics. The depth can be created if you deeply feel. So already if you are creating a depth with just a machine, if you have the inner depth also, certainly that graphical presentation will be more ornamental and more realistic and lifeful, isn't it so? So, creative meditation is the second thing. Third thing is blind drawing exercise. You must not see anything at all. Whenever you start to see something, then immediately you lose your capability of creativity. I do not mean that you must close your eyes while coming to office, going to home, etc. You must practice also a system of drawing known as blind drawing, in which you must try to draw lines and geometrical structures, physiometric structures in the form of human beings, then scape structures and also geographical structures in the form of plateaus, valleys, plains, the designs, the hillocks, the forestry, the green flesh, everything you can draw blind. It is known as blind drawing. Every day you have to practice 20 minutes of drawing, closing your eyes. Only there must be an extension or connectivity between your mind and dexterity without the intrusion or verification or the path follow-up of your optical support to assure that it is going properly or not. So without verification, without guiding, or without having a proper way of instruction, it is known as optical instruction. if you draw a line without seeing, you will be having only 30-40% of skill. If you see that while being drawn, it is the optical guidelines or optical verification which makes you to move in the correct path. So a person can develop more skills. If a person can closing his eyes or her eyes, if he can draw a perfect structure, beautiful structure with a extra and exact way of presentation, certainly by opening the eyes, especially with a machine, it will be hypervalent and the performance will be extremely, exorbitantly stupendous and fabulous, isn't it so? So that is known as blind drawing. The fourth thing is, it is a cognitive skill. It is cognitive creativity. Every day, whether it is a fact or fiction or fable, whatever it may be, it may be a fact, it may be a fable, it may be a fiction, you try to do something. Whatever that is enjoyable, I used to say, there are two things which are enjoyed. Whenever those things are hyper-processed or those things are subjected to super-evaluation, for example, animals with the human behavior, that is enjoyable. You are seeing Tom and Jerry, everything, they wear dresses, they speak, they are having office, they are writing, they are having wives and children, and they are going for picnic, they are fighting, everything. So, subspecies with human being and human being with the superhuman behavior. He-man, everything, you are seeing lot of people, superhuman behavior. And even it may be a quixotic or it may be a ridiculous behavior like Johnny Bravo, everything, etc. There are innumerable things in fiction, you may be knowing it better than me. So likewise, it is known as fiction. In fiction, anything, the normalcy is appreciated by means of an enhancement. Suspicious for special standards, special things for super special standards. So a person must have two things. One is a faculty, also with a fictional end. Person having real fiction, he can have only entertainment, not enlightenment. Person having only faculty, they cannot have both entertainment and enlightenment. Because we are all just human beings, we want contrary exposure. What is it known as? Contrary exposure. If you work lot, immediately you must be exposed to a contrary area where you relax. If you eat lot, then there must be a starving or a fasting process. If you speak last, there must be a mauna vrata. If you move last, at least you must be having a posture to sit and meditate. For everything you must need a contrary exposure. Speech, silence. Movement, meditation. Giving, taking. That policy is not there, only taking. So there is known as contrary exposure. So we can have both the things. One is fiction. Fiction is the science of dealing with unimaginabilities. And faculty that deals with the most practical and immediately adaptable things. A person governing both the things, he will be having a lightened mind and enlightened brain. This is very much required for the modern society. The fifth thing is known as coordinative intelligence. Fifth thing is known as coordinative intelligence. The first thing, I have narrated Panchasiddhis, so this is the last thing among them. What is coordinative intelligence? Applying creativity in all fields. There are two ways of coordinative intelligence. One, if you are taking graphics, applying your graphical skills in molding your children, in maintaining the relations, in maintaining a frictionless, lubricated relations in office and maintaining your own self in ease, peace and comfort, that can be applied. And wherever you see things which are worthy of absorption and practice, you can convert them into graphical skills. So if graphics is your destination, you will be having extra destinal factors and destinal factors. You are working on graphics, but your whole life is not on graphics. Isn't it so? So you are with the graphics. And you are not for exclusively graphics, you are having multiple dimensions of your life. So applying the pattern of logics that exists in graphics in all walks of life. What is the beauty? How is the assembly? Same thing you adopt in your family. That is a convertible thing. And likewise, you will be seeing a lot of things in your family, within your relations, within your experiences, bitterness and better things. You will be seeing a lot of things that you can apply to develop graphical intelligence. There are three exercises very simply for that which somebody should note down. Yesterday I told about Nadi, today I am telling about these things, tomorrow there will be a different faculty. So it goes without saying that nothing has been very systematically progressed and processed. So certainly these things will help the people lot. So summarizing the speech, we must have the basic skills which are God-given, which are human in nature, by which you can have a machine independent, self-inbuilt creative knowledge, or a good machine supporting knowledge, or a machine operative intelligence without any ill effects, side effects, back effects and bad effects. For that you need these types of skills. So I told about blind drawing exercise. You can start from tomorrow, you can start that blind drawing. Then the creativity meditation, that is also very much useful. And now I have told about coordinating your intelligence, graphic intelligence, with the other walks of life and other walks of life intelligence, and whatever you see there you try to impart and translate it into your graphical skills. Then it is a type of cognitive creativity, by means daily you have to make a picture and just to store them daily. Today, starting from today, before going to sleep or just rising from the bed, you draw something or imagine about something. It may be different, it may be something distinct, it may be deformed, it may be just ludicrous, or irrespective of the style and status, try to do something. That is known as cognitive creativity. If you think one thing and if you have a process or a sequential flow of the thoughts, tomorrow you'll be having a better thing. Tomorrow I will give you an experiment. You draw one thing without saying anything. It is known as a casual coincidental exercise. That is known as phenomenon of coincidence and phenomenon of accidents. It is known as yadruchavada, yadrucha ikyavada. I will say to 100 people here to write a word, and that word must not be having any role in any languages of the world known to you. How can you say about unknown languages? Known languages, that word must not have occurred as per your knowledge. You have to just simply to say, you have to bluff something. And you have to put the meaning for your bluffing. For example, Juju, that means fan. Somebody writes like that. If you mix with 100%, finally you test it. At least in that 100 people, there is a proximity or the resemblance or the identical possibility of somebody writing Juju or Jajja or Jaja, something like that. Really, it may be identical, something it may be at least approximate. If you mix it with 1 lakh people or 10 lakhs of people within millions, then the same thing, Juju means fan, will be certainly found. It is known as the phenomenon of accidentalism or coincidentalism. I'm telling an exercise, it is not a joke. You don't know about the miracles of your mind. We have been very much accustomed with pets and machines. We really know very little about ourselves and human beings. Then how to know about God? So you draw something. You draw something. Daily you draw something and write something in connection, whatever you feel. Within 1 month or 2 months, you will be meeting a similar exercise in your performance. Certainly, I swear it. Certainly something connected, related, resemblant, proximate, intimate, exact, identical, something will happen in your life. Because there is a global clock of incidents and you are also a part inside that. And somehow you have to meet with the incidents of your future plans, proposals and projects. You are thinking that the projects or future is somewhere very distant and different from us, and we are different. It is not so. The project is also moving like where, and you are also moving in your same direction. Then because you don't have clairvoyance or telepathy or television or telecognition, so we cannot feel. But a casual exercising of your desires and presentations, you will certainly feel there is a faculty inside the mind for that. It is acquaintance. It is known as acquaintance of futuristics, or it is known as extensive acquaintance. For example, even without thinking, you will be having a lot of thoughts of meeting people and speaking things. Whenever you are meeting that person and speaking the same thing, you will then feel that, somehow I have seen a person like this, or the same person in my dream, or in realization, or something between a dream and realization, or my hallucination it may be, I have spoken the same words. So a person's pictorial as well as the phonal resemblance of even our message, at least a person, they could have among 98% of the society, they could have experienced at least once or twice in one decade. Certainly, minimum. So this type of cognitive creativity is daily you draw something. Immediately, persons who are having low IQ, certainly at the type of any arduous and Herculean exercises, they will feel that somehow they are induced to contribute more, to succeed more. And this is the first wonder. First wonder is, more than your performance skill, more than your expected, assumed or understood performance skill by yourself and by your comrades and the management, you will be doing something extra. The second thing is, whatever you are very casually, accidentally, unconnectively doing at some area, point of there is some angular meet, we used to call it, creates an angle by mutual meet. There will be an angular meet for your that is useless or the so-called connectionless drawing with a proposed project which is there for the development of your professional standards. It will certainly have a meaning in your life. The final thing to develop all of these things, even this creative meditation, the coordinating intelligence and the cognitive creativity and this type of drawing by means of your blindness without optical guidance, four things can be more enriched and empowered. They can be scintillized and sanctified by means of meditation of a grand design model of the structure, that is the cosmography. Cosmography is the world model. If you read about the model of the person who made the model, that is ontography, that is studying about the God, Bhagavad Swarupa, that is ontography, grand design model. So if you make these five exercises, certainly that will give you mission independence and effective support of yourself to the missions. Three things: innovative phenomena, creative intelligence enrichment, total all resulting in new methods of informing entertainment, education, ethical and various other global issues can be settled, and various other global necessary issues can be promoted, and it can be also a divine tool for installing peace and promotion of prosperity in the world. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.